things are frustrating. It just won't go together.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Naomi Home Presents. I'm Jason, and today we'll be demonstrating some drawer assemblies, everything from the slider to a friction to a bearing glide and everything in between. We're going to help you put together your drawers as well as make sure those glides go on correctly. And then if you've ever been kind of in a situation, maybe putting together some drawers, you're running into some trouble getting them to align correctly, didn't want to go on correctly, well, this is the video for you. We're going to help you get over those issues. So feel free to go ahead and get your product together, everything from your assembly instructions, maybe a pen and a paper in case you want to take some notes, and let's go ahead and get started.
The first thing is to gather your tool. We'll need a screwdriver and a hammer perhaps. In addition, you're going to want to make sure you have a copy of our assembly instructions handy. And as well, take your time to organize all of your parts and make sure they're laid out in a fashion that makes sense for assembly. From there, you're going to go through each of these hardware packs. They are usually labeled, so make sure you pay close attention to the actual hardware pieces that you're going to need to use based on what's in the assembly instructions. But if you really need additional help, a lot of our products have assembly videos already created that illustrate the parts and details that you'll need throughout the process. So go ahead and get yourself organized, and then join me back here at the video. One great tip is to make sure you always have the groove side pointing inward on all of your pieces. So when we roll them all up, the groove will align with all of the other parts. But we'll get into more detail on that later. Let's go ahead and take out our hardware and begin with the drawer assembly. The first step is to get the drawer's back panel as well as two D screws. Now we're going to take the drawer's right side panel and align that to the back panel. I recommend that you use a hand screwdriver for this because if you over tighten it, it can in fact strip the wood out or it can also split the wood. When tightening our panels, leave a little bit of slack in it, and then we'll tighten it all the way down at the very end. That way, if there's any need for a little bit of adjustment later on, we'll have a bit of play in it, but not too much because we don't want it all floppy over. Okay, so we're going to repeat the same thing for the left side panel. Two more D screws of our pack, and we'll align it again with the back panel. So now we've got both side panels onto our back panel with a little bit of slack in it. From there, we'll take our bottom panel, and you'll want to make sure that you have the nice painted side face up. Now we're going to take our drawer front, and we're going to use two cam bolts and connect them into our drawer front. Tighten all the way down until they're snug. Next, we're going to need to take two cam locks as well as two wooden dowels. Those wooden dowels are going to go into the holes of the drawer on the drawer front, and then we're going to align our holes up. But before I do that, we're going to take our cam lock, and it's very important that you note that it kind of looks like a plus sign, but there is a little bit of an arrow on it. The arrow you will always want to point in the direction of the bolt. So let's put the cam lock in the hole with the arrow facing outward. I don't know if you can see it, but in this scenario, it's not lined up very nicely. What do I need to do? Well, all I need to do is to take my screwdriver and align it so that the arrow is facing toward the front. So now we're going to do that on the other side as well. Connect the front panel and rotate the cam lock until it stops. Now that all the pieces are in place, we're going to go to the back and tighten our screws. You don't need to over-tighten them, you just want them to be snug. For those who prefer to assemble with an electric screwdriver, make sure that you have it set down to about 2 or 3, and then go ahead and put in your screw. And you'll see how it kicked out and didn't over-tighten the screw by using a lower setting. Simple as that. Our drawer is now assembled.
We're here now going to demonstrate some of the other options we have with our drawers and cabinets.
First off, one of our lowest entry options is the simple friction drawer. It's basic and it rides just inside the cabinet. You just kind of push it in and out. There's no stopper, so they can come back out. It's not made to hold any major amount of content. It's really designed to hold maybe a remote or maybe some glasses or something like that. From there, moving up the scale, we have our Taylor cabinet. This one uses a slide. It's a plastic type of apparatus that rides inside the tracker drawer. So if we show you the drawer here, the drawer itself will have a track that this plastic insert will go into, and it will ride in between there. Okay, so that is this slider. So now moving up into our AMI cabinet. So this is the roller glider. The wheel is on the bottom of the glide toward the front. So when I bring in the drawer at an angle, they're going to go ahead and ride in there. And the rest of that other wheel is going to ride in the track right there. And then when you want to take the drawer out, you just do the opposite. You go ahead and lift up the front. And now we're onto the Debbie cabinet with the bearing glide. This metal apparatus here has these small little bearings inside here. When you receive your unit with a bearing glider, it is generally going to have glides already together. So you will have to take those apart. If you see that here, there's a small bit of a U shape. It's a bit of a hook, and you want to press down on that hook, okay? And then the two pieces will come apart. One thing to note is when you're working with a bearing glide, it is and will sometimes feel a bit sticky, but it's not glue. It's a lubricant that is on there to keep your bearings running nice and smooth. So when you're inserting into your drawer box, you'll want to make sure again that your apparatus with the bearings is all the way forward. And then when you bring your drawer box in, it's going to slide directly in, and then you'll hear it click. And then it'll ride nicely inside the glider.
So there you have it. Your Naomi Home drawers and cabinets are now complete. Be sure to like us and subscribe. As well, check out our channel for more Naomi Home content and other videos for assemblies and more information regarding your product. And thank you again for watching. We'll see you again next time.